So Michael Harrison, of course, was introduced today by Mayor Catherine Pugh. This is day one of him being on the job as acting police commissioner of Baltimore City. C4 joins us. Your impressions of what he had to say this morning?
Well, he touched on the right bases. I mean, he talked about the necessity to work within the consent decree that, of course, he was under when he was in New Orleans. He talked about getting with the business community and trying to figure out what their needs were, going to all 9 police districts and talking with all the community. So he touched all the right bases. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, though, he's going to be defined and measured by how he can reduce violence.
Absolutely. I mean, that's what we all hope to happen, no matter what side of the aisle you're on, of course.
But will he get help? See, the question is, will he face some of the resistance and opposition that commissioners in the past have faced when they, for instance, go after juvenile violence? Not juvenile crime, the difference between juvenile violence and juvenile crime, as Commissioner Davis faced, or other initiatives where they try to push forward, will the city council or state legislators get in their way? That's really the question.
Absolutely. And we've had many police commissioners, of course.
At least 5 in the last year.
A few years, it's been crazy. So when was the last time you, C4, and maybe never, really felt that the city was on the right track in regards to...
Believe it or not too long ago, and she calls in on a regular basis on my show, Mayor Sheila Dixon. Mm-hmm. When Mayor Dixon was in office and she appointed Fred Bielfeld to be police commissioner, we saw unprecedented levels of reduction of crime. We got down under 200 homicides, believe it or not, within this decade, within 2010 through 2019. People forget, Christy, back in 2014, we only had 211 homicides. So we've seen this big 300 each year since 2015 to now. So it can be done. The question is, will all partners in the criminal justice system, judges, state's attorney, police, parole and probation, will they all work together to keep violent people off the streets?
True.
That's the question.
Yeah, absolutely. What was it about Bielfeld and Sheila Dixon, that combination?
Well, first, she let him do the work without interfering, you know, from the mayor's position. And also, I'm going to say again, Patricia Jessamy was the state's attorney at the time beginning. Then we had Greg Bernstein. But the judges, state's attorney, everybody said violent criminals are a focus. If you commit violence, use a gun. He used to call it bad guys with guns. Mm-hmm. We're going to get you off the streets. And we don't see that now. Like this shooting at Frederick Douglass High School. Apparently, this 25-year-old in his history has a gun charge. Why is he on the streets at 25 years old with a gun charge in his background when the mandatory minimum is 5 years? Why is he on the street?
C4, how important is this appointment for the mayor?
It's defining. This is her ability to either run for re-election or not. She will be measured on her re-election bid based on the violence in this city and whether she's able, with this commissioner, to significantly reduce it. If it doesn't happen, she's a one-term mayor.
And do you have any advice for the new commissioner? What would you say?
Well, you know, the advice for other commissioners long before him was rent, don't buy, because of the nature of the turnover. I mean, think about it. Since 2000 to now, we've had 10, or is it 11? 11 police commissioners in 19 years. My advice would be to, when something is going wrong, tell it. Come out in the public and say, I'm receiving a block here, somebody's not helping me. Let the public know where his opposition is. Because most people are for him. They want to see him reduce crime. So in other words, don't keep it behind closed doors. Tell on people. Remember as a kid, tell on folks?
Oh, yeah.
Tell on people.
See something, say something.
That's right.
So, C4, what's next? You spoke with
Councilman Brandon Scott
today.
The process
next?
Is he's going to meet with the community groups, he's going to meet with the business community. March the 4th is what we're hearing, his actual vote on his confirmation. So in the meantime, what I'm hoping he will do is stress to the rank and file that you can't wait till March the 4th. We had a homicide over the weekend. We had a couple of non-fatal shootings Saturday. So whatever he's doing to touch bases, the police department needs to effectively fight crime now. Not let the month of February go like January. We had 26 homicides in the month of January. So he's got to hit the ground now and make something happen before March the 4th.
I appreciate your feedback. You, of course, are
a city resident.
I am a city resident. We are, and anybody even around the areas, it doesn't matter. We're all vested in this. So thank you.
Thank you, Christy.
Listen to the C4 Show weekdays 9 to 1 on WBAL and get a complete recap of Acting Police Commissioner Michael Harrison's introductory press conference, plus analysis and reaction in a one-hour special tonight at 7 on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.